In this lesson, I want to talk about different ways to select text. I'm working in the pc.html file, and I'll start the live preview. The gist with the shortcuts and notes I'm adding are linked to in the lesson notes. If you haven't watched the last lesson on moving your cursor around, you might want to, because those shortcuts are the basis for selecting text. If you know those shortcuts, by just adding the Shift key to the shortcut, you will be selecting text. Today I'm recording on my PC. The Mac shortcuts are different, just like they were in the last lesson. However, adding Shift to your shortcuts is the way to select text on both platforms. So if you understand the shortcuts from the last lesson, you should be able to select text. Of course, it is possible to make selections with your mouse, and I still do that at times. But I found getting comfortable selecting with my keyboard makes me more efficient. I'm not going to demonstrate all these shortcuts because that would be really tedious, but I would encourage you to try them on your own so you see how they work. The ones I use the most often are selecting words or characters. Let's say I duplicate a header and want to change the text in it. It's easy to just select both words by holding Shift+Ctrl+Arrow, and then I can type the new words. On a Mac, that would be Shift+Alt+Arrow. I'm going to paste in the gist code for the new shortcuts now. I used to use the Shift+Up or Down Arrow shortcuts to select lines of text. The problem with this shortcut is that you need to be at the beginning of the line to do it correctly. If you're in the middle of a line, this happens. Of course, you can use the shortcuts to move your cursor to the beginning of the line, but that's still extra steps. So when I discovered the Ctrl+L shortcut, I started using that one instead. It doesn't matter where your cursor is, the entire line will get selected when you hit that shortcut. And if you hit it again, it will select the next line. So this is usually a better way to select groups of text. This shortcut is the same on both PCs and Macs. Another great shortcut is Ctrl+Cmd+B, which allows you to select the current word. Again, it doesn't matter where your cursor is, so this is why I use this shortcut usually instead of the Shift+Arrow keys. This is also usually faster than using the delete key to erase the word character by character. I have a mistake in the last lesson that I want to fix. I typed the word two multiple times on a few lines. I could just delete the characters with a delete key, but sometimes I like to select the word first and see it highlighted before I delete. So I'll use the shortcut to select and delete these extra words. This shortcut is actually part of the multiple cursor functionality, which I'll discuss in a future lesson. However, I use this shortcut often to select just one word at a time. Finally, a simple shortcut that works in most applications is Ctrl+Cmd+A to select everything in the file. You probably already know that one. I would say it's good to learn all the shortcuts for selecting text with the Shift key because those shortcuts will work for you in many other applications, not just brackets. I use some of those shortcuts when I'm editing an email or a post, for example. However, the two shortcuts for selecting a line of text, Ctrl+L or the current word, Ctrl+Cmd+B, are two of my most used shortcuts when I'm editing code, so I'd try to remember those first. There is more to learn about selecting text with brackets and the multiple cursor functionality. There are also other things to learn about editing files. However, before we get to that, I want to do something a little more fun and work with some CSS, so we'll do that in the next lesson.